McCarthy's men are going to need all their stamina, strength, and skill to challenge a world-class side. Join Network 2 as Ireland meets Sweden in an international friendly this Wednesday at 7:15 on Network 2.
Still to come this afternoon, we have the new adventures of Robin Hood at 4:15, and then you've a chance to catch up on the week's events in Fur City at 5:15. But first here in two, it's action all the way as we bring you live coverage of the All-Ireland League Rugby semi-final from Cork.
One place in this year's AIB final remains unfilled. Will it be Cork Constitution, the winners of the inaugural All-Ireland League in 1991? Or can Buccaneers, the Cinderella of the competition, continue to go from strength to strength and become the first Connacht team to make the final? Yes, good afternoon, and you're very welcome indeed to Temple Hill here in Cork for this second semi-final in the AIB League between Cork Con and the Bucks. Well, it's already been a great weekend of rugby up to this, certainly if you're from Limerick anyway, that's for sure. That's after the first semi-final in Dura Doyle yesterday between Gary Owen and St Mary's. Now, as I'm sure you well know already, in that match, Gary Owen secured the first of the places in next weekend's final by the narrowest of margins, by the most dramatic way possible. Well, today, it's Cork Con and Buccaneers. They play for the right to line out next Saturday in Lansdowne Road. Well, looking forward to that match with me right now. He was in Limerick with us yesterday, Tony Waugh. Tony, the big question, can the Bucks do it at all, do you think?
Well, it's a great occasion. I mean, the black and amber all over the place, they're here in strength. The answer is yes, they can. It's going to be very difficult. Cork Con obviously are favourites, but if they play the rugby they're best at, keep it tight, get their big props going, Jimmy Screen and Martin Cal, anything is possible.
What's the best chance for Buccaneers?
Well, I think they've got to keep it tight. Certainly they won't be sorry to, with all the rain we've had here in Cork overnight. It's quite nice now, but it's done a lot of damage to the pitch. It's quite soft underfoot. That will suit them. They'll keep it tight. They'll get their big forwards going forward. The Rigneys, I mean, Brian, Dez, they're there in strength. But I think Cahill and Screen, they're crucial to the cause.
Well, yesterday you were in your jumper in Dura Doyle. It was cold, bitterly cold and rainy. You've got the coat today. But in actual fact, the weather's been holding up okay.
Yes, it is. It's quite pleasant at the moment. And Cork can play a very rounded game. I mean, if they can get the ball wide. And they're particularly strong in the key area, around the back row and also in midfield. Ronan Garrett has really been on fire of late, and Brian O'Mara's coming back to form. I think if Con can get it away from the tight situations, then they are going to come through at the end of the day.
OK, Tony, thank you very much for the moment. Well, now, before a ball is kicked in anger at all here in Cork today, this already is a historic occasion because the Buccaneers are looking to be the first Connacht club to play in the final of this new format. This from a team, of course, who just won promotion from Division 2 last season. Well, before we get to the live action, let's just recap then on the season so far for both of these sides.
Cork Con, champions of the inaugural league back in 1991. Since then, the title has eluded them. The Limerick clubs, the dominant force in the league. Cork Con have always had tremendous individual talent. This year's performances, though, have married that with a steeliness and consistency which has seen them hover at the top of the league for most of the season. Opposition at the beginning of the year and beat them 35-25, continuing their winning ways. Yeah, weekend, they sealed a semi-final home tie and put paid to Shannon's dreams of making it five titles in a row. The first game of the season saw the two newly promoted Western teams go head-to-head. For Buccaneers, it was to be one of many victories which sent them on a path to the playoffs, but it also set the tone for a season of contrasting fortunes for the Connacht sides. Victories from 11 outings, a remarkable return for First Division debutants, and along the way they captured some illustrious scalps. Then, last week, the league decider. The opponents Lansdowne, the venue Ballinasloe, the biggest day in the club's history. It proved to be an historic victory.
Well, both teams managed 8 victories from 11 games during the league phase. Their only meeting this season was here in Cork, the home side running out 32-25 winners on the day. So Cork not only with home advantage today, but maybe a little psychological advantage as well with that victory in January. OK, well, with me here now in the presentation box, I have Jim Glennon. Jim, you're very welcome. Great crowd here in the ground. Looks very well. A good atmosphere, obviously, for this match.
Yeah, marvellous atmosphere. And I think it has to be said, Michael, that 80% of it has been contributed by Buccaneers. They're a great crowd. They're very refreshing for the game. And hopefully they'll get a result today. They certainly won't be disgraced. There's no doubt at all about that.
Jim, atmosphere adds to the occasion, but it doesn't win matches. It's up to the 15 guys down there on the field and those around them. Buccaneers have a big test today, let's face it.
Yeah, they have a huge task, without a shadow of a doubt. I was travelling down on the train this morning and I was talking to a Cork man, a knowledgeable man in the game, and he suggested that today there'd be 15 piano lifters playing against 15 piano players. Yeah. And there was no doubt who he felt the players would be. I wouldn't agree with him, I have to say. I think there are two very well-balanced sides. The result here earlier on in the league certainly showed how tightly balanced the thing was. Cork-Con won by 32-25. Buccaneers have only lost 3 away games this year, and that was one of them. Today, I think they'll give them a really good game. If they're still in it with 20 minutes to go, they'll be very, very hard to beat. And certainly, if Connor to have a chance of winning, they have to get off to a very good start.
Along the way, people have been talking about Buccaneers coming unstuck eventually at some stage. That's presumably been something of a spur to them as they've gone to these league semi-finals.
Well, I think people have been talking about Buccaneers coming unstuck for the last 4 years. They've made their way up right through the divisions, and they're now... I think, having seen them earlier in the year, in their rightful place at the top of the First Division. How they fare in the knockout situation against the side of the calibre and of the traditions of Cork-Con, with two of the most astute men in the background, Paddy Durham and Mickey Bradley, we just have to wait and see how that pans out. But they're certainly where they deserve to be, and I wouldn't expect to see the Buccaneers' wheels coming off the rails for a long time to come yet, regardless of today's result.
Okay, Jim, the team's just about to come out. Quick prediction, who's going to win this one?
I think it has to be Cork-Con. The head says Cork-Con, but I think the heart of 90% of the people here will say Buccaneers. Hopefully it will be.
All right, well, we have to wait and see what happens then, Jim Glennon. Thank you for the moment. Well, Tony Ward has made his way over to the commentary position where he's joining Jim Sherwin.
Thanks very much, Michael. Well, here we are. Stage is set for the second semi-final. Who is going to join Gary Owen? Lansdowne Road next Saturday. Big question. Big match. And here come the hosts, Cork-Con, led by Brian O'Mara today. Phillips Oden, the club captain, is on the bench. And Brian O'Mara leads them out. David Corkery coming down. Frankie Sheehan. Out they come. And a packed house here at Temple Hill. Well, the starting lineup for the home team today shows just one change from the side which beat Shannon last week. Alan Byrne is preferred at number 12 in the centre to Cian Mahoney, who sits on the bench. And Brian O'Mara will captain the side which has struck a rich vein of form in their recent league games. That's Cork-Con for you. And now the visitors. The Bucks field the same side, bar one, which started against Lansdowne. Their pack is built around the Rigney family, and there's another one on the bench. And their props are fresh from their success as part of the Ireland A-team against Italy. Behind the scrum, Simon Allnut is the playmaker in a back line with loads of talent and lots of tries between them. We're ready to go now, and here he is, the man in the middle, Alan Lewis. Big day for him today, international referee, of course. And by a curious coincidence, his touch judges today are black and white. Gordon Black and Murray White. So we're nearly ready to go. What a big match this is. Previous encounters between them will count for nothing. Tony, a quick word.
That's a huge occasion, and there's a fantastic following for Buccaneers here today. The black and amber is like young Munsters at their best. There's about 1,500, I'm told, down from the west, and they're going to enjoy this. Big, big game for Bucs. Here we go.
There's the whistle. And all that gets us going. Huge game, this. Up goes Donald Sheen. But look at that for a surge for Bucs. Straight away, MacIver to all over the top goal in the first seconds. Whoa! Relief for Calm there. After only 16 seconds, Bucs could have taken the lead. What a sting that might have been.
Control the name of the game. I mean, Bucs driving in, making the ball available. He stroked it nicely, unfortunately, just to the left of the post. What a start that would have been.
That surely would. He's had a pretty good season, Simon Allnut, with the boot in every sense of the word. But he has only had one drop goal so far. So away we go again. Nice take that by Martin Stafford. Once again, big long pass from MacIver. Switch move was well read there by Conn. Man with the white cap, scrum hat, is Ultan O'Callaghan. Another big one. Oh, that's a Gary Owen and a half, and Brian Walsh is going to be in trouble under this one. He did very well and called the mark and was given it. Brave catch by the fullback. Away we go. Well, there's confidence for you. He's only got one man with him out here. Now, fortunately, Alan Byrne took his eye off that. But free kick to Conn. O'Mara. Well, there's the intention playing straight away. Conn prepared to run it at every opportunity as Frankie Sheehan feeds the ball in. And in the tackle, Bucs didn't roll away. Tony, I think it's worth having a little word about the pitch, because the weather has been ferocious, as we know, in this part of the world. Today, though, it's brightened up considerably, but the pitch, what do you think?
It's a little bit soft underfoot. We had a lot of rain in Cork overnight, Jim, and certainly in Ballinasloe, it was almost wrapped in heaven and sent them. They love those conditions, Buccaneers. But there's no doubt, you made the point already about the intent. Twice Conor got the ball, twice they tried to move it wide, once to the right, once to the left. I expect them to try and keep it as cool as they can. So.
Well, that's only about at 28th of the support that Bucs have brought with them from the west. And here's Frankie Sheehan on his home ground, right in front of all those noisy Bucs men. Frankie Sheehan throwing for Sheehan, the other Sheehan, Donald. Ultan O'Callaghan. Munster into provincial, leading that surge. Ken Murphy, number five. O'Mara shouting at his forwards to keep it going, but they're going to have to play it now as the move breaks down. O'Mara, O'Gara. And that's another Gary Owen. This is a tricky one here. Oh dear, that's going to be a penalty against Conn. They're tackling the man in the air without the ball. And Alan Lewis wants a word with Jerry Murray, I think. Committed to the tackle, Tony.
And that is very dangerous. I mean, as Romney is going to take the ball there, Jerry Murray hits him that little bit area. That's very, very dangerous indeed. Alan Lewis is on the spot and he's picked it up.
Yeah, that's unbelievable. That a fella could really get hurt. Yeah. Fullback, of course, or any defender in that position is absolutely vulnerable. In the air, eye on the ball, no idea who's coming at him, no way of protecting himself.
That is the point, is the fact that his eyes are focused very much, total concentration on the ball. Yeah. And it was a beautiful Gary Owen as well from Ronan O'Gara, hanging up there, his forwards arriving in time.
Actually, do you see there?
Yes, I think I was
just about to say that. He actually tripped over Frankie Sheehan, I think.
Yeah, I don't think there was any intent there at all. He just slipped in. Yeah. Unfortunately, hopefully the fullback, Robert Lee, is not hurt.
Mm. Well, it was good to see it from that angle, actually, because you could see that. I don't think it was completely Jerry Murray's fault there. Still, at the end of the day, it's not the stuffing out of Robert Lee. Certainly felt that.
He had a big game in Ballinasloe last week as well, and he came off injured in that game.
Yes.
Albeit I think it was a leg injury he had. He's okay, thankfully, stable. He played very, very well last week in the big one against Lansdowne.
the end of all that, it's a penalty to Bucks. There they are, in force. There can't be anybody left west of the Shannon, I think. And if they get through here today, well, they'll have everybody with them from Connacht. And then some next week. Big prize at stake, of course, for both of them. If Conn win, they will face Gary Owen in a repeat of the 91 final, which they won. If Bucks win, it'll be the absolute epitome of everything they wanted since they merged in 92. Joe McVeigh now with the throw. Six at the back is Des Rigney. McIver, nice ball with the screen. Seven is Owen Brennan, and that's a very good move. They've gained about 30 metres here. Once again, using the big prop forward, down he goes. He's gained another 10 metres forward. Now Allnut inside to Cobb. And they have once more. Now is there a gap there for Skyver? It's nearly there, and Brian Rigney, their captain, has it. And once again they have. They're finding it a bit tougher, though, at this stage. Now Cobb with the chip. It's going too far. It's bouncing beautifully, and well cleared. But that's real ground gain for Buccaneers.
That's a wonderful phase of play by the Buccaneers. And there we saw their real strength. First, they managed to set Jimmy Screen loose. Once he gets going forward, he has the bulk to get the momentum. We then saw Martin Cowell taking the ball in the middle of the field. Brian Rigney retaining it. Skyver, Steve McIver, the scrum half, having a cut. And then eventually Owen Cobb putting a lovely weighted ball into the corner.
Yes, he's well known as Skyver, although it's just a short version of Stephen McIver. And he does answer to it. Here's another opportunity, Tony. They were all together here, weren't they? And there was the chip.
Yes, they were. And again, control is the name of the game. When the ball was set back, all the time in the world. But Owen Cobb has played much of his rugby at out half as well. He was a school's international out half, my memory serves me right, when he was in Pres Bray, I think. But that's a lovely weighted kick to the corner, which means Connor forced to put the ball across the touchline. Therefore, it's a Buccaneers put in. And every opportunity to win their own ball, perhaps roll all the way to the line.
And that's where we are. About 10 metres, I suppose, from the Conn line. And thrown to the back for a Steffert. And it's a scrum to Conn, first one of the match. A lot of conversation going on between Alan Lewis and the respective front rows. And that's a greeting and a half for both sets of props. I think one of the other things, Tony, that we have to watch, particularly down the ends of the pitch where it's likely to get cut up a bit more than other places, is how the props are going to hold their feet in conditions like this.
Yes, I know there's quite a amount of water, as you say, at both ends of the field, and inside the 22s, I think they're going to have great difficulty in that respect.
Right. So another lecture. Number one, not much hair. Jimmy Screen, plenty of brawn. O'Mara from a steady scrum. Nice ball from O'Gara. He didn't have much time to work with there, but my goodness, did he clear his lines. Lovely kick by the out half. That's a smashing start.
And he's a player playing with real confidence this season, and he's really come good at late. Not only is he kicking well, which we all know he can do, but he can break, and most important of all, he's scoring tries.
Indeed he is. He's got three of them so far. Here's an under 21. 97. Here's McVeigh. Oh, looking for Steffert again. They're finding it a little difficult to hold onto their ball there, but not when they get it out in conditions like this. Once again, they use big Jimmy Screen, and picked up by McIver into Des Rigney. Now, the Conn cover is stretched across the field, and that was a difficult one for Allnut to take. Just lost contact with his scrum half there for a moment. Chance here for Conn. Rigney holds on because he knew there was only one man out there, and Conn just being over-anxious, getting themselves offside. Well, it's kickable, Tony. The breeze is, I think, probably in his favour. In his favour, I think. The flags I'm looking at the far end of the pitch, way to our right now, are blowing left to right as he looks at the posts. But he's not going to have a go. I think it's a bit tricky from there.
I must admit, I agree with you. I'm a little bit surprised at that. I thought he would have had a go. It looked certainly from here to be within his range, but he obviously, he's the man who matters out there.
Oh, yes. Thank you for coming. Yes, there is a lot of that, all right. Here's McVeigh on the Conn 22. A nice jump, that. by Donal Rigney. If I say Rigney, I'm bound to get at least half the bucks pack right, Tony. So I only have to say Rigney and we're there.
And what, another one in reserve, isn't there? Three on another the field at the reserve, moment, yeah. One more to come, certainly.
And a penalty against Conn for pulling down the line-out. Putting down the man. Now, this is definitely kickable, and I think he really have a goal from here.
Yes. Yeah, I think this time he certainly has to have a goal. But even mentioning the Rigneys, the four of them involved at the moment, as you know, there's one other one, Niall Rigney, who played for Greystones, and potentially he looked to be the player who really was going to go places representative-wise, but a bad injury, unfortunately. Yeah, here we see here, in the end, this is what Bucks are good at. Once they get that ball, they're driving forward, and that's Des Rigney trying to clear Ulton O'Callaghan, I think it is, out of the way, and that's what upset the Conn players. But the referee felt they were killing the ball. I presume it was Ulton O'Callaghan and penalised, and an opportunity for Simon Olna to put Buccaneers into the lead.
Here we are, 10 minutes gone. You'd have to say that it had been all Buccaneers so far. They've been down here more often than Conn have been in their half. And that's what he's looking at. Crowd going quiet, as they always do. It's on its way, but it's not there. It's across the face of the posts. And that is one, as they say, he'll be disappointed with. He should have made it. It was kickable, but it's not the side of the pitch, Tony. As a kicker yourself, you'd know that right footer's favour.
And yet, having watched him all season, he's been kicking so consistently well for Buccaneers and indeed for Connacht when he came in, that he will be disappointed with that. But that certainly was an opportunity to put Buccaneers into the lead.
An opportunity he hasn't got. Here's the Conn coach, Michael Bradley, who was captain, and Paddy Durham beside him, who's the other coach. And Michael Bradley was captain of the Conn side that won the inaugural league in 91. Nice break this. There they come. Here's Corker now, and Sheehan. That's a bit of momentum going now. O'Gara up the middle. Byrne. And they've stolen it, and Owen Brennan's the man to take it up, and here we go, kind of, Ronan O'Gara has stolen it back. Just getting a little bit edgy there. A few mistakes creeping in. Adrenaline pumping on both sides. Here we are. Ulton O'Callaghan at the bottom of that, and that was nicely laid up there for Owen Brennan, thank you very much. Now Brian O'Mara to put in. He's really come back into form, this scrum half. O'Mara. Kelly. Hammered by Des Rigney. Ulton O'Callaghan once again getting his body between the box and the ball. And here's Ronan O'Gara running into a flurry of black and ambers. I wonder what Brian O'Mara is going to do here, Tony. Will he just ask O'Gara to kick them upfield a bit? Should.
Yes, I think so, but he's going to go up the line. I think the contrast in styles is interesting. When Conn take it into the ruck, immediately they're looking at the point of contact to get it away again, whereas Buccaneers are quite content to take it on to get the Conn forwards involved.
And that's a beauty. That's as far into Bucks territory as Conn have been so far. 13 minutes gone. A lot will depend on how this young man plays today. They've left Ulton O'Callaghan out, but unfortunately, Donal Sheehan knocked it on with a penalty against Conn, a penalty against Bucks. And this is definitely kickable. And the penalty is against Buccaneers for being within the 10-metre mark. And this is what Ronan O'Gara is going to see on the 22. Well, now, Eddie O'Sullivan and his group on the Buccaneers bench. Mike Rue missing that one a couple of minutes ago. Breeze is blowing right to left. As he faces the ball, Ronan O'Gara. Oh, well, now he's pulled it too. And the breeze, I think, might have taken a bit of a hold of that. He did seem to aim it at the right post, but it's still level, 0-0 after just coming up to a quarter of an hour. Another let off, so each side has had their escape.
But I think Ronan O'Gara will be disappointed with that one, Jim, because when you miss a kick as a kicker on the right-hand side of the post, you don't want to miss any, but when you do, it's not too bad on the left.
Here's Brian Walsh to set Conn going again, trying to find a little gap down there. And Robert Lee won't like that. He was just ahead of the ball, Tony, wasn't he?
A well-angled kick by the Cork Conn fullback. It was, the referee's right, he did knock the ball forward.
So a real advantage here for Conn. They've got all their big runners in the middle. Jerry Murray, number 7. 3 is John O'Driscoll. And Alan Lewis, determined that the front rows are not going to cause him a problem today. O'Callaghan doing a Victor Costello, feeding inside to David Corkery. Sheehan has it there now, O'Mara, and a drop goal from Ronan O'Gara, and it too has gone to the right. Well, each out half has had a missed penalty and a missed drop goal, and after just 16 minutes, 0-0. This is what he was looking at, Tony.
Yeah, I think it's nerves all round, because again he'd lots of time, he seemed to strike it quite well, but it drifted at that time just to the right of the post, and again disappointment. So 0-0 it remains,
all not to restart. That's a tricky one. O'Mara on halfway. O'Callaghan to do crash ball up the middle. Tackled first of all by Joe McVeigh, and second phase for Conn. And the ref just couldn't put up with that, and neither can Conn. And they're overreacting here. And that's unnecessary. It doesn't take much for all hell to break loose, but it shouldn't have erupted for that. Elton O'Callaghan is still on the ground. There was a Buccaneers leg on the offside position there, as we'll see, I'm sure. But suddenly the Conn players all reacted in a bunch. Here's O'Callaghan, tackled by Brennan. And down they go. And the Bucs were definitely offside there, stopping the ball coming back. And you saw the way there that I think it might have been John O'Driscoll and Frankie Sheehan objected. And then Ian Murray joined in. Suddenly Brian Rigney was there. Then Martin Cahill. They were all at it. So a conference now between the referee and Murray White and Elton O'Callaghan, the first to go to ground. And I think that Conn people feel that there was a little shooing going on there. Murray White, also a representative referee now, having a long conversation with Alan Lewis. So it's Brian Rigney and Ken Murphy being called out. That's Ken Murphy, came from Cove Pirates, and Brian Rigney, Buccaneers captain. Stern enough lecture. I think it's a useful ploy in this situation for the referee, probably to take more time, Tony, than he needs to make the point, because it does calm things down a bit.
Interesting, in the end, Alan Lewis gave the double penalty. In other words, he was awarding the penalty to the Buccaneers, and then he gave it to Conn. I would say I thought the penalty was for Conn in the first place.
Yes. O'Gara. That's a nice kick. That really is a stunning kick. I think he won't have that one back. Here we are again. That's where it all went wrong. I think the overreaction by Carl, and then Rigney through a punch, and then Ian Murray, and here go Conn on the rumble, up to the Bucs line. They're there, over, and he's giving the try. Well, there's so many of them there. David Corkery thinks it's his, but actually John O'Driscoll thinks it's his. And he's the man with the ball, so I think we'll credit the prop forward with it. Here is the line-out jump, lovely one by Jerry Murray. Up they go. bucks all over the place, totally disorganized, in disarray as that tight wedge forced its way over the line. I don't think the referee had any choice.
No, the referee is right. In the end, it's simplicity itself. Jerry Murray's so small, he's simple to lift up. He gets it at the back. Then it's a matter of just organising themselves. They're in numbers. Yes! Books are disorganised. The referee is on the spot, and I don't think there's any doubt that's certainly a try for Corkon.
Well, first score of the game. Now, this is a much more difficult kick than he had the first time. I'd say there's less pressure on him now. Ronan O'Gara then to make it seven. No, it's got away again on him, I'm afraid. The breeze must be catching it, I think, once it gets up there.
Oh, but again, I don't think he's striking well. Your target there when you're kicking from the right-hand side should always be the near goal post, and that time again it drifted across the face of the goal, so not well struck.
Here's another chance. Up goes Murray. Just watch number three there. He's on the left of things as they stand. He's there, and they're all there, and there's no way there's a Bucks body underneath that. Try John O'Driscoll. Away we go again. That's John O'Driscoll's first try in the competition. That's into no man's land. That's Conor Gormley underneath that. I think it's the first time he's actually got a good feel of the ball today. Ref just asking the players now, guys, to slow down, pay attention, concentrate on the match. You've got to settle things down, he says. There's no doubt it's edgy at the moment. It could boil over in any second. Stand up, says Alan Lewis. Frankie Sheehan there in the middle of the con front row. John O'Driscoll, the try scorer, nearest us. Still a lot of trouble in the front rows. Put it in quickly, says the ref to McIver. Stafford holds it. It's nearly gone the whole 90. Yes, it has now. Squared onto the touchline, the scrum must be. Oof, there's a lot of poundage going in there. Free kick. Buccaneers into Brennan. That's a lot of ground gained. He's taken down by Sheehan. Donal went forward from Brennan's scrum. Corkon.
And that's disappointing because Brennan made good yardage there. But the referee spotted it and quite correctly gives the put in to Corkon.
Con now to attack. The men on either side of the scrum. O'Callaghan feeding Brian O'Mara. And a terrific tackle that by Stafford. Watch the scrum half on the break. Nailed him. Good tackle. And out of it, Con killed the heel. Mara was nearly away there, Tony.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. A vital tackle by Stafford off the base of the scrum because it looked as if Mara was through the gap. And if he got away, he was clean through.
This is the way it was. This 8-9 move opens up the pitch considerably, so the back row man has to keep his eye on the breaking scrum half, and it was a good tackle.
And it's all about timing. Timing you break off the back row, because obviously the advantage is with the attacking player in that case, O'Mara.
Now let's have a look at what Allnut is going to do here from behind the posts. He's had one penalty kick at goal. And a drop goal attempt. This is the first time he's been on the correct side, if you like, for the right footer. Twenty-five penalties he's kicked so far. Now add one more to that, and Bucks are on the board. Simon Allnut coming into this match had 111 points to his total, 25 penalties among them. And there he is. Nice strike, Tony.
Yes, it was, and that'll certainly calm the nerves, having missed the drop goal and the one from the right earlier on. That time he got it right on the meat. Beautiful strike.
They look a little happier. Long way to go, though. And the sun's come out. That's unbelievable. Certainly the dry day will suit Corkon, I think, Tony, better than it will Buccaneers.
There's no doubt, although, as we said earlier on, the damage has already been done underfoot. But Corkon, the drier it is, and the more fluid the game, the better it suits Con, as you say.
Both sides have identical records coming into this particular semi-final. They've both played 11, won 8, lost 3 in their only encounter. Conn won by 7 points, 32-25. And I see that the ref is referring to the fact that his touch judge on the far side of the field was watching Jimmy screen there. And there's a gilt-edged chance lost. Buccaneers turn it over, referee plays advantage. Fed out to Allnut from MacIver. In they come with Cobb. They've made a lot of ground, they're 50 metres up the field and they're using screen once again. Sheehan and O'Callaghan put him down. But this good possession, this. All the way across, and that's a lovely move. Here's Stuart Traynor. Now he's being faced by two because he got past him. Being well put down there by Conor Mahony. It was a good tackle and he's penalised. Actually, Stuart Traynor's not penalised, although he thought he was the one. But Buccaneers are penalised for not staying on their feet. Lovely move, overlap.
Yes, the first time we've seen Buccaneers move the ball on each side. A lovely time pass down the right, first of all, from Simon Allnut, and then to release his backline into the open out left. I think in the end, Jim, he penalised Conor Gormley for going to ground.
Yes, for not staying on his feet, that's right. Here we are again. Just see the way the move came in. You see Martin Stafford in the line. That was Cobb. There's Stafford in the line, and here's Stuart Traynor now, galloping away, faced by Brian Walsh, tried to step inside, it just couldn't quite hold his feet. Conor Gormley put him down, and that's where Owen Cobb didn't stay on his feet. As you said, Tony, good decision. And from the line out, it's a scrum to Buccaneers. 2 points between them, one score. Early days to sing Fields of Athenry, but it's a support gesture as well, I think. MacIver. O'Mara. Felt he could grab Stafford there and did play on. Nice break once again. Screen trying to go on his own. Trying to make those crucial 4 or 5 yards to get over the gain line. Here's Allnut. Cobb once again on the switch move. Inside to Gormley. And they're underneath the Conn posts and they're driving and rolling forward. There isn't anybody out here except Stuart Traynor. And that's why Cobb held on to it. Allnut now, Lee, Stuart Traynor has to step inside, has to go on, he's very close, and they have it, and they're in. The ref has a quick look, not sure he can decide, no.
Smashing play by the Buccaneers, and that must have been very close indeed, Jim. Here we'll see it just again. When Tom Stuart Traynor gets this, the gap seems to open up for him. He goes low for the line, eventually he goes to ground. Now it's when the ball comes back here to see that, I'm not sure which player actually gets it here. It's one of the forwards. Again, I think it could be Martin Callan. No, I think it's a good decision by the referee, and he's in the right position. The ball was not grounded.
Not grounded. So there was a bit of a stoppage to one of the Conn players there. And must just have a quick look there. You see number 12 there for Buccaneers. That's Conor Gormley, very like with Tom Stuart Traynor, the two blonde hairs. And Owen Cobb, it's a good bit darker. So actually, it was Conor Gormley who gave away that penalty a few minutes ago. And that's the size of the Buccaneers pack. Formidable. Here's Ken Murphy. A bit of a shoulder injury. Now, let's see what Buccaneers can do here. Stuart Traynor standing way back. Might be an 8-9 move once again. The Conn get a big shove on. That's terrific defensive play by the home side. But now they force the ball out of play. That was very good defensive play by the Conn pack.
Yes, indeed. A good shove by the Conn pack. I think the timing was a part of the problem there. Steve MacIver seemed to put it in before the front row were ready. As a result, Conn got the push on. Good defensive play, as you say.
Nice sunshine. And packed house here at Temple Hill. Sheehan now to try and find his man. Murphy's at two, and right towards the back to Murray. And the penalty against Buccaneers for deliberately collapsing, and they're going to be penalised another 10 for objecting. And
Alan Lewis getting very cross with Owen Brennan, deciding he's going to put his mark on this match, and Owen Brennan may, but it'll have to be on the field. Up now almost to the Conn 10-metre mark. Good look now, John O'Driscoll in the front for Conn. Jimmy Screen about to lift, and Rigney about to lift as well. See if they can block. Up go the jumpers, and they did enough to get in O'Callaghan's way. Yes, well timed that jump. They didn't really try to catch it, Buccaneers, but they just wanted to put the jumper off. Six is Des Rigney, formerly captain of Greystones. I don't think you were playing at the time, Tony, were you, when he was there?
Yeah, he came just the season before I finished, so I played a bit with Des.
Slightly scrappy, but it's visitor's ball. Martin Cahill this time. Taken in, not used. Home side ball. So 10 minutes to go, and a full penalty against Buccaneers. And Brian Rigney now being called out. This isn't the first time. Want to be very careful, the Bucs people. Talk to your team, tell them to settle down, because somebody's going to go to the sin bin if I have to speak to somebody again, he said. There's Martin Cahill. He's almost ageless, although he's actually only 22. Stuart Traynor under it. Has to keep it in play. Who's going to take that one? Nobody seemed to want it. Now Corkery. Got a lot of pace. And it's out on the full. He won't be happy. Won't be happy. In a way, he really should have given it to the fullback, Tony.
Yeah, I think he was a little bit undecided, David Corkery. In the end, I'd say it was marginal. He must have been just outside, but Gordon Black was on the spot and he picked it up. And as you say, that's a mistake by the Cork Constitution flanker.
Really trying to regain his confidence these days, David Corkery. He'd love to be in the party to go to Australia. We've got a few people to get past first. Quinnegan, Ward, Brennan. He was in the party to South Africa. Tour didn't go all that well for him. So now he's back playing with Conn and reveling in the atmosphere here at Temple Hill. Meanwhile, all nut. And that's Gormley. And they have it once more. Which way will McIver go? All going himself. Well, Sheehan didn't buy the dummy. But it's still good possession for Buccaneers. Deep inside the Conn 22. They're fighting it hard. That's Cobb. Fighting it hard, Buccaneers, to get past that last line of defence. Conn defence resolute. Trying to drag Conn offside. Here's Rigney. Runs into Corkery. And O'Callaghan. And Murray. Now, what can Screen do? Can't do it all on his own. Ball comes down to Des Rigney. Owen Brennan in there. They've overrun it a little bit. And a penalty against Conn. And certainly Brian O'Mara didn't like that one bit.
I don't know why, Jim. I mean, that was a blatant penalty at the end. Two or three Conn players went in and killed the ball. I don't know if we'll see it here at the end. Now, superb defence by Conn all the way across. Des Rigney in the end going through. But look there, David Corkery is deliberately falling down on the ball. That is a penalty. End of story.
Yeah, O'Gara furious. Nice tackle by O'Gara on that 18-stone weakling, Jimmy Screen.
The recycling of the ball there, absolutely superb by Buccaneers for what, almost a minute continuously.
They're good at that. And this to give Buccaneers the lead. One from two. It's there. My goodness, it wobbled a bit, didn't it?
A little bit of close, you can actually tell it by his body language. He wasn't there, and there you can see by his smile. Yeah, that was very, very close, I can tell you.
Wow.
Here we are. Buccaneers lead Constitution by 6.5.
Well, went through the right side for him. And that is the lead. 6 minutes or so to go. Cork Con 5, Buccaneers 6. Balance of possession certainly with the visitors, Tony. I think they've been attacking the Con line more often than Con have been attacking. Although, when Con have got down there, they've always looked very dangerous. McIver trying to get them up over halfway. Up comes Brian Walsh on his own 10-metre mark. Took a bit of taking down that. Eventually, Mike Devine got him on halfway, and Bucks roll again. Donal Sheehan. McIver once again kicking because he knows that Brian Walsh was out of position. That was a very clever kick by the scrum half. And across comes Conor Mahoney. And Bucks have gained about 50, 60 metres. Good play.
Absolutely right. Good play by McIver. He spotted that Walsh had got caught. Turned over, ball on the Buccaneers' side. But Buccaneers, Jim, they're doing the basics well. It's a bit like St. Mary's in the second half yesterday. Conor making silly mistakes, but it's all a result of bread and butter basic pressure that Buccaneers are imposing at the moment.
Brian Walsh is holding things up. He's slowly making his way back. There he is. Got a bit of damage on the halfway line. Brian Walsh, member of the 1991 team, which won the competition the first year. He scored 5 tries. Of course, played in the A team this year until Simon Mason came on the scene. And after his performance for Ulster, you couldn't keep him out. And up goes Donal Rigney. Was selected last week but didn't play for Bucks. And look at this for a roll. Terrific stuff. Martin Siffert going in. Even Silent All not going in to help. And they're looking for it now. And Screen looking to dive over himself. He must be close. And the ref won't give it. Ref says he was held up. Buccaneers scrum. And hard to see. But it's definitely a Buccaneers 5-metre scrum. Let's see if we can see it again. Just watch Jimmy Screen, number one. There it is. Picks it up anyway. And there he goes. And it's a penalty from the scrum. It is a penalty to Buccaneers. And it's good! Wonderful! Very good try by Owen Brennan from the fringe of the scrum. They just took the quick penalty and in they went. Well, they deserve it. They have pushed and pressurised the Con defence all afternoon. And just watch it again. Quickly taken by McIver. In went Stafford, palmed it to his wing forward. Quick dive over the line, and not even Ulster O'Callaghan could stop it. Good try, well deserved. And Owen Brennan scores his 2nd try of the competition. Lovely wing forwards try. And here's Allnut now. Allnut. One conversion. Two penalties so far. Now this one conversion. It's there. He hit it a fair old smack. And that certainly has opened it up a little bit. Cork Con now 5, Buccaneers 13. Here we are, Tony.
Yes, and once the referee awards the penalty again, just as Pat Humphreys, the Gary Owen hooker, did yesterday, it's quick thinking by Steve McIver. Martin Stafford has had a marvellous first half, and equally Eamon Brennan there on his shoulder, and a fully deserved try for Buccaneers. We've got a game.
There won't be too much time to be added on, although you never know these days. Just wonder, you know, after the 7 or 8 minutes you had yesterday, Tony, and Dura Doyle, the end of the match, whether in fact the timing should be done off the pitch.
Yes, I agree with that. I think that's an introduction we are going to see in time, excuse the pun, but certainly we need it, yes.
I didn't notice it. Now it's Con's turn. That's the Buccaneers 22. Time now for Buccaneers to show what they can do in defence. And Con would certainly like to pull back a bit of that lead before half-time. McVeigh talking to Brian Rigney. and MacIver.
Yes, you're right. They do need to pull it back because even playing into a very strong wind, Buccaneers, by virtue of their style of play, are one team who don't worry in the least about playing into a strong wind because of the style of game they play. So certainly that won't faze them in the least, I can assure you.
Oddly enough, you know, Owen Brennan, who scored that try, got his only other try in the match against Conn. Conn mustn't bring this down. And look at the wedge that Buccaneers have formed. Peeling off the static maul, lost it forward. Almost injury time now. Were perhaps a few stoppages, and then of course we had the lengthy chats between the referee and the various captains. But it has settled down in the last 5 minutes. Still Alan Lewis, former international cricketer, captain of Ireland, scored over 100 one down. Very talented. And now making his mark on the international scene. That's a lovely kick from Allnut. It really is a terrific kick into open country. Who's going to pick it up, Walsh or Kelly? Fullback. Well, certainly needed. Conor Mahoney there, and it's a nice break by the centre. Solidly built young man. In they go, and they have O'Mara, O'Gara, Alan Byrne. Over halfway, and Corkery just spilled it a bit. Advantage being played to Buccaneers, and they roll forward again. They are formidable, very well organised. They really do hunt together as a pack. Scrum to Conn. Minute of stoppage time added already. And an entertaining match this has been. So. Somebody hurt on the far side of that huddle over there. Can't quite see who it is just yet. I think it's Donal Rigney. And he's looking at the Bucks front row again, saying, I want as good a scrum as the last time. Be good boys now. Do as I say and you'll be fine. Ooh, in they go. O'Mara. Channel 2. Out to Byrne. Trying to breach the initial line of defence. And he did well that time, Brian Walsh, to take that ball. Really wasn't easy. Corkery in support. Inside the Buccaneers' half. O'Mara scrambling for it. O'Gara decides not to give it to O'Callaghan. He's made a lot of ground. Good break that by the out half. And a penalty against Buccaneers for not staying on their feet. Oh, my goodness me. Conn, again, not happy with the way Bucks people are acting. He's calling over Mike Devine. Let's see what he's doing here. He's giving him a yellow card. Let's see what happens. Here comes O'Gara. Cross comes Devine. It was Devine who hit him. Now what happened next? He won't get off the ball, that's for sure. And then I think O'Mara hit him on the way up. I didn't see a punch being thrown there by Mike Devine, but the referee must have seen something else. Ronan O'Gara, 30 penalties coming into this match. A total of 125 points. Well, he hasn't been successful with his kicks from the far side of the field. 3 minutes of injury time played, and the flags go up and the flags come down, and Ronan O'Gara has kicked the penalty. Made a big difference to the score. That was very good. And that's where we are at half-time. Cork Conn 8 with the try scored by John O'Driscoll and the penalty by Ronan O'Gara. And Buccaneers are 13 with Allnut and Brennan having scored a try. Allnut 2 penalties and a conversion, and that's where we are. Cork Conn 8, Buccaneers 13. Join us in a few moments for the second half.
AI AIB, pleased to support club rugby in Ireland. Make the most of longer days with Speakeasy from ESAT Digiphone. For just £99, you get a top-of-the-range GSM mobile phone with no bills, no credit checks, and a £20 EaseKey card included. Speakeasy. Just pay and speak.
Ketchup.
Grass and yuck.
I'm going to teach you how to get these out.
Bung in the detergent. Check it's at 40 degrees.
And use some of this too.
Ace bleach.
Ace is a different type of bleach. It boosts your detergent without bleaching colours.
But does it make a difference?
Ketchup's gone. The yuck's gone. Ace is different.
And the rest of the load?
Brilliant. And it hasn't changed the colours.
You learn something new every day, don't you, Mum?
Ace boosts your detergent to boot out stains.
I had always hoped to see this in my lifetime. I have been wondering about the mysteries of the universe since I was a child. Yet, looking at the beauty of these things still fills me with wonder. For me, physics is about seeing further, better, and deeper. And from here, I can see forever. My eyesight means a lot to me.
Print correction roller. Quick, clean, and accurate.
AIB, pleased to support club rugby in Ireland.
Welcome back again to Temple Hill. So then at half-time, it's the Buccaneers who lead by 13 points to 8. Jim Glennon, the dream is still there for them.
Very much so, and I think deservedly so. They've played remarkably good football in the first half once they settled. Seemed to me to be somewhat unsure of themselves, a bit lacking in confidence, and never really gave themselves a chance to get into a rhythm. Made a lot of basic mistakes, incurred the wrath of referee Alan Lewis on a few occasions, and the only ones they have to blame for not being further ahead at this stage are themselves.
Jim, let's quickly take a look at those two tries. And the first one was the first score of the match, and of course Cork gone getting off to the ideal start for them, I suppose.
Yeah, certainly an excellent, superbly executed line-out. Gerry Murray, the open side flanker, great take. And while John O'Driscoll was credited with the try, I think every one of the eight forwards have deserved a share in the credit. That was a great bit of quick thinking by Steve McIver, the Buccaneers scrum half. Gave it to Martin Stafford, who was, as ever, available on his shoulder. And Steve Brennan went in and took the score. Fully deserved try for Buccaneers, it has to be said.
All right, Jim, that's the situation then at half-time. An intriguing second half in prospect, to say the very least of it. Let's go back again to Jim Sherwin.
Thanks very much, Michael. Absolutely spot on. It is an intriguing match, isn't it? Absolutely evenly balanced. One try between them now. Wonder if that penalty just before half-time is going to prove crucial. Big difference between 5-13 and 8-13. Bucks slow to break up.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Tony, you wouldn't bet against Buccaneers at this stage, would you?
No, you certainly wouldn't, Jim. The point I was making before the interval about the wind not making a great difference, that certainly applies. I think perhaps I'm stating the obvious, but I think the next score is a very, very important one for both sides, for many obvious reasons. But Buccaneers aren't out of this by a long shot.
Number five is Donal Rigney. played his rugby with Portlaoise. Number three, Martin Cahill. Ronan O'Gara prepares to get us going again. And away we go. MacIver. What an interesting career he's had. Three international caps. Olna now to slow things down a little bit. Michael Cahill there. Michael Stafford. Allnut. Cork-Con coming into this match. Lost to Lansdowne. Lost to Young Munster. And beat Blackrock. Lost to Gary Owen. And then won the rest of them. So they're really are on a roll now since the second half of the season. MacIver thinks it's his and Brian Rigney wants to help. There it is. Allnut. Inside to Gormley. And what a great tackle by O'Gara. And he's penalised for holding after the tackle. Interesting decision here. And no doubt in O'Gara's mind what he wants to do.
That's demoralising for the Buccaneers forwards. I mean, they were in control there. Brian Rigney gave it back to Steve MacIver. And once it goes into the middle of the field, and not only do they not get across the game line, but conceding a penalty and an obvious opportunity for O'Gara to put more points on the board. It's frustrating for forwards because they then feel, well, look, we've got to hold on to this ourselves. Disappointing.
Well, he'll be confident enough because of the last kick, which went over. Having a good look at this one. If he hits it straight, it'll go in. Yeah. On its way, and it looks good. And it is good. Now, there's not much between them at all. Cork-Con 11, Buccaneers 13. Two vital strikes by Ronan O'Gara. Just before and after. Every time Cork-Con get within striking distance, they seem to score, Tony. Buccaneers have to work much harder for their scores.
Yes, and two beautiful kicks, as you said, by Ronan O'Gara, and a lovely break for the one before half-time that I didn't get a chance to mention. But yes, O'Gara struck the last two very, very well.
That was clever play by the full-back, Lee, trapping the ball as it was beginning to behave a bit erratically. Buccaneers trying to keep Con out at the moment. Now it's Con's turn to roll forward. Michael Bradley had a strong chat with them at half time. Bucks asking the ref why he didn't blow sooner, but they've got the scrum now. MacIver. And here we go. That's a good move by Kelly. Inside to Sheehan. Donal Sheehan. And suddenly they have pierced the Buccaneers' defence inside their 22. And Buccaneers trying to hold them out. Hard to know which side had the ball there for a second, but Buccaneers in possession now. Allnut standing a long way behind his scrum half there. He had plenty of time to move and kick. It was a good pass from MacIver, and Allnut cleared the line. Nicely done. What a season Buccaneers have had. They started off with a 21-14 win against Galwegians, then lost to Clontarf, beat Terenure, beat St Mary's. I think the biggest blow to their pride was going to Thomond Park and losing 3-29 to Shannon. That was a big blow, but they weathered the storm there and they've won the last five games. And that has seen them here. A place in the top four and a place in the semi-final. Nice play that by Stuart Traynor. Kept his eye on it. Side going forward, get the advantage of the put in. The crowd over there really love that. Rather restrained support from Croc Conn, Tony, I think, but there's no doubting where they're from.
And there are Barons all over the place as well, I can assure you, on that side. We can hear them banging away. Lovely kick by Steve McIver. He does that box kick particularly well, and Stuart Traynor managing to take it on the end. Here's a substitution now for Croc Conn.
Here's Anthony Horgan. Anthony Horgan on. Professional rugby player, one of the under 21s. On in the centre now. And Conn beginning to infringe a bit, and the ref won't let Stefford take a quick one. David Corkery, the culprit, laying the ball on the ground, says Alan Lewis. Now, all not. See the flags over there just blowing into the Buccaneers' faces this half. See how the ground he gains with that one. Well, the breeze held that up a bit. See Conn have tried to get the better of that noise, and it won't be all that easy. Dick Sale and Barons. Conn have switched their players around. They've put John Kelly into the centre and Anthony Horgan on the wing. He'll be the one with the cleanest shirt out there on the right far side of the pitch. Ball not straight from the line out. The scrum has settled down, I think, considerably. Alan Lewis. Oh, he was going to give a free kick against Buccaneers, and he changed that to a penalty. And he's obviously going to free anything he sees in there. He said to Brian Rigney, I've asked him to deliver and he's not delivering, so I'm not quite sure whether it's Martin Cahill or Jimmy Screen, but the result is a long-range right-footer from Ronan O'Gara. Short line this time. They're throwing it to Sheehan. Sheehan to Sheehan. O'Mara to O'Gara. Lovely ball into Corkery. Jerry Murray there helping, and the rest of the back row and the pack have now arrived. Here's O'Gara once again. A nice little chip from O'Mahony. Over comes Kelly, who's gone into the centre, and it's must be a try! It is! Oh, Buccaneers will be so dejected. Donald Rigney overran it, and John Kelly is in. Well, he'll never get a softer try than that. Absolutely handed to him on a plate. Lovely move, O'Gara. Little chip by Conor Mahony. Here's Kelly coming up. Oh, it seemed to be well covered by Donald Rigney, and it bounced up absolutely perfectly. On a plate, John Kelly says, thank you very much indeed.
What a sweet chip that is. I think it was Conor Mahony put it in. Ball bouncing very unkindly for Buccaneers into John Kelly's hands.
Absolutely.
In he goes.
There's O'Gara. It's Kelly's fourth try. O'Gara with the conversion. No. Actually, never looked like it. Never looked like it at all. John Kelly has scored four tries now. One against Gary Owen, one against Mary's, one against Shannon, and now he gives Croc Conn the lead. There we are once again. Nice move, nice pass from O'Mara. O'Gara, the little pop, and perfectly placed. But what cruel luck for Donald Rigney. Kelly won't mind, though. And the lead changing hands. Good to see. Keeps the match absolutely wide open. Great stuff. If it's a semi-final. Straight down to Stuart Traynor. Horgan. Getting his shirt dirty for the first time in the match. Ref shouting at somebody to let it go. It seems to be in Conn's favour. Saw something in there that required a little word with Stephen McIver. This is the Buccaneers' 10-metre mark. Scrum is not square. Right shoulders, lads. Oh, He's done a good job, Alan Lewis. It's not that easy keeping control in there because they're very keen to be at each other. And he freed Buccaneers a little while ago. Now he's freed Cork Con. So, full penalty. All not. Made good use of that. Breeze has got up a bit. It'll affect the kind of high balls. It's a lovely day in Cork now.
They're two very sweet strikers of the ball out of their hands, both Simon Alden up there in picture and also Ronan O'Gara. They really hit it well.
16 penalties in all in the match so far. Here's Joe McVeigh. Skippy. Throwing to Rigney. Goal. That's a good move. That's a drive and a half. Stafford, MacIver wants MacIver to Brennan. Trying to breach the first line of defence, but O'Mara got him around the ankles first. Con crowd disappointed with that decision.
And that time I think they have a case. That was a big hit by Alton O'Callaghan on Eamon Brennan as he went forward, and he appeared to turn him in the tackle and smother the ball. So Con, I think justifiably, were looking for the put in there.
O'Callaghan, the second man, I think, to stop Brennan's run. And that's Brennan on the floor. Oh, Brennan came through regional colleges. He's been around the Athlone scene for a while. Scored his second try now in the competition. A nice gesture from the Con captain, Brian O'Mara. Frankie Sheehan. They're in good voice, aren't they? Side 3 points down, the time to give them a bit of support. Ooh. They're still at it. MacIver. Martin Cahill and Ian Murray having a great battle today. Martin Stafford, taken by O'Gara and Murray. Now, second phase into Brian Rigney. Step, go to ground, hit the deck. Alton O'Callaghan's in the way here. Oh, it's a penalty against Buccaneers. That's interesting. Well, and once again, he's penalising Buccaneers for not staying on their feet.
Well. Again, like David McHugh yesterday, he has been consistent in that respect and penalising both teams. He wants players, quite rightly, to stay on their feet. But Buccaneers will be very disappointed with
this. Yes. O'Gara with the advantage of the breeze. It's in. Let's see what we can find out here. Here's Martin Stafford, O'Gara and Murray taking him, then Alton O'Callaghan coming in. Now watch where number 8 is here. Here's Rigney stepping, O'Callaghan coming in on the wrong side, absolutely. And who didn't stay on their feet? There was a body in there who went in over the top.
I think it was Joe McVeigh first in.
Might have been. Anyway, it's coming down to Horgan. To the 10-metre mark. Offloading to Kelly. Breaking down in midfield, O'Mara. Clever kick behind Stuart Traynor. It's going a long way down towards the line. And now it's out of play. 13 minutes of the second half gone. From 13-5 to 16-13.
An intelligent kick by O'Mara nonetheless. I know it didn't cross for the touch that he was looking for, but at least it didn't reach the in-goal area whereby we'd win the scrum back.
Still plenty of time. I wonder how many more twists this match has before we finish. All not. O'Callaghan. He's knocked on. Ken Murphy, number 5. Not quite sure that he knocked it on, but he tried to tidy it up. Advantage Buccaneers. Great occasion here at Temple Hill today. Really superb. Stafford doing the Victor Costolo break off the scrum, peeling off the side, but they're not over the gain line yet. Now Allnut trying to make his way past Murray, not succeeding. Buccaneers flare hurt. Slow to recover.
And even though the Buccaneers' recycling and their rumbling close in is very effective, I mean, as we've said, that's the strength of the side. The Cork-Con fringe defending has been very good throughout so far. There's some big hits going in and some vital turnovers as a result. Yet another one there.
Let's see what we can happen here. Here's Stafford. That's Murray. I think it is Murray, actually, who's hurt. Down he goes. Stafford goes over the top of him. And Murray's down there. Yeah. It's not Murray anyway, because Murray is standing up. Might be Alton O'Callaghan. He certainly went over very awkwardly, all right. And that's taking a bit of time. Alton O'Callaghan, when he's not playing rugby, is a rugby development officer with the Irish Rugby Football Union and works for the Munster branch. So he's plenty of opportunities. And you could say he's not enjoying himself. There he is. That's very sore. Very sore indeed. Another very talented player, the under-21s. Of course, a Munster inter-provincial. And he's no excuse for not staying fit, Tony, having to go and talk to schools and clubs around the province here.
I actually think he's a very underrated player. He was in the Munster side at the start of the year as a number six, and I tell you, anything on the sore side, he really bottles up. He's a very physical player, very, very strong, as we can see, but it looks like he's coming off now.
And we'll have another look at it as John Fogarty begins to warm up. There's Murray, and there's O'Callaghan with the hat. Now watch him go over and crash. He really did hit himself in the shoulder there. Nasty.
Number 20, John Fogarty.
Pat O'Keefe brings him off. He's done a good job for Con today. And John Fogarty's on as well. He's also a member of the under-21 squad, so there's plenty of talent in reserve, Cork Con. Be interesting to see now how Fogarty fits into this. He's gone to the open side. And Corkery's gone to number 8. Nice move, this. Ryan Walton, here's an easy run in for O'Brien. O'Brien does a wing it try. Back in action. Well, that's a great try by David O'Brien. Marketing student, Prez boy, here in Cork. And that's certainly set Con on the way. That's great, he's delighted with that. Now, here's the kick, and that's a much better kick indeed by Ronan O'Gara. That's the hardest of the kicks he's had today from that side of the field, but he's made it good now. And suddenly the difference is 10 points the other way. 5-13 they were trailing at one stage, and now look where they are again. There's Conor Mahony. Brian Walsh timed his pass absolutely perfectly. If the winger hadn't scored that, there would have been questions asked afterwards, but it's very, very satisfying all the same. And David O'Brien got a try against Lansdowne and 3 against Galwegians. So now he's added 1 against Buccaneers. Off we go again. They're certainly beginning to string their games together much better now. Here come Buccaneers. What can they do about this? Brian Walsh He's coming more and more into this match, making an extra man in the three quarters, and Buccaneers are finding it hard to deal with him. That's a perfectly placed kick. Oh, super stuff. Lovely kick. Now, Buccaneers have a lot to do here. 10 points difference. So here we are. Stepper trying to work his way out of defence. Ah, oh, what could Jimmy Screen do? Nothing. But well rescued all the same. Here's Allnut, and he's through the first line. He just about stayed on his feet there. But great covering that by O'Gara and Murray. That wake forward covers the ground very, very fast. Brennan goes down. They've crossed the halfway line. MacIver wants to push them further. That is just too far. Simon Allnut, lovely break. I'm back with you, I think. So we're just inside the Conn half. And another stoppage. Ken Murphy's the man. Just needs to breathe a bit. 20 there, John Fogarty. See what happens here again. And here's the Allnut break. He was half stopped. There was almost an ankle tap there from Anthony Horgan, but eventually O'Gara and Murray got him. Kelly now playing in the centre. Let's see if we can find out where Ken Murphy was. I think he's at the bottom of that. And that's all not. Brian Rigney's coming off. And he's been replaced by his brother. So, great performance this by the veteran, Brian Rigney. 8 caps for Ireland. And Colum is number 18. We'll see him now in just a minute. And he's straight away into the action. There he is there. Well, back goes Stuart Traynor, and it's gone over the dead ball line. Was it touched? Seems to have been touched, the ref says. And if it was, then it'll be a scrum. Well, that's an interesting one. Stuart Traynor must have touched it just in the in-goal area.
Yes, I think so. I think that was the referee's interpretation anyway. I must admit, I didn't see it, but that's what the referee seemed to say, and that being the case, yes, it is a scrum.
It's amazing the difference it makes, you know, if Conn score from here. It'll be really curtains for Buccaneers when they could have had the scrum back in halfway. But here's this penalty. I wonder if we'll see if they're going to take a quick one here, or will they just slow it down and take 3 points? What are they going to do? Corkery says, let's have a little meeting about it. See if you can give me number 18, Buccaneers, please. So they're going to have a shot at goal. Now here we are. This is the kick by Conn. Let's see if we can see whether, in fact, did it bounce off the Buccaneers' hand there? It might have. Let's see what happens. Down it comes. And Stuart Traynor following it. Bounces over the goal line now. And let's see. he watched it anyway, I think. So it must have been just touched on the kick.
Yeah, I think that has to be the logical explanation, because certainly Stuart Traynor didn't seem to go near it. It must have been in the attempted block down.
23-13. O'Gara. 3 kicks for 5. 2 penalties and 2 conversions, and away it goes. This one is looking better, and it's there. And once again, Ronan O'Gara. puts his stamp on a match. And that is going to make it very difficult indeed now for the Buccaneers team to come back.
And what a huge influence on proceedings Ronan O'Gara has had in the match so far, but certainly in the second half, he's been brilliant.
Since he kicked that penalty just before half-time, he's been full of confidence and very accurate. It's the first time that Bucks have been inside the count, 22, and here's an impossible try, but it's over the dead ball line and Brennan won't get a second. Well, frightening moment that for Conn. And the charge down was just too forceful. Conn will take their time over this, I've no doubt. Let's see what happens here. O'Mara, I know Brennan was in very fast, but it just shot away from everybody. Here's the kick away by O'Gara, and Brennan once again. But it's just always going to go over the dead ball line. A very short dead ball area, in-goal area there. MacIver now, tackled by Fogarty. The Bucks' 10-metre mark. Screen once again. But they're watching him for that. They're watching all day. They know it's one of the Bucks' favourite moves. And Bucks try it all the time. He does sometimes make some ground for them, and he certainly sets up very good second phase, Tony, but when you've got fringe tacklers watching for it, it doesn't always work.
And Conn are playing it so simply and so sensibly in that regard. They're kicking deep, they're coming up in numbers, and it's a hell of a long way back for Buccaneers.
Buccaneers have got to get two converted tries before they can do anything here. But they're trying. See what Cobb can do. That's Brennan, try scorer. It's past Murray at the first attempt, and it's gone forward. And I'll tell you, John Fogarty has made an impact since he's come on. It was a timely tackle. And Stuart Traynor. But it's with you, it's with you. And when it's going against you, it's not really with you at all. Perhaps in the first half, Stuart Traynor would have caught that.
But what a beautiful kick it was. So close to the touchline there. And certainly they're getting the best of the ball now. It's a pity because that was good counter-attacking play by Buccaneers in the first place. But this one almost judged to perfection. So I'm sure he claimed that anyway. Yes, it was a beautiful kick.
And so we're back again with Jimmy Screen on the lift. In they come now for the scrum. It'll be 15 metres in from the touchline, obviously. And O'Brien O'Mara to put in. Well, the chat has Screen and O'Driscoll have been at close quarters all day. Just looking down here at the Bucks bench. And I think we will be able to see number 18, Rigney, in a moment. Now, here goes Cahill. 18 there, Colin Rigney. Well, they're trying. Sticking at the minute. There's over anxious hands going in. Pass is just not going to hand. It's Tom Stuart Traynor. The smiles have disappeared a bit from those loyal supporters. John O'Driscoll coming off. Philip Soden coming on. Philip is the club captain for Conn this year. Brian O'Mara is the captain on the field this afternoon. It has been today. A good performance that by John O'Driscoll. Now, O'Mara. Long pass. But a very good kick from O'Gara. That goes Devine. Lee has it now. Wants to keep it in play. O'Mara taking it. Walsh with him. There he is, the fullback. Made a big impact when he's come into the line. O'Mara now must go to the open side. O'Gara. Not quite sure what skiff that was. Kelly going in. Corgan at the bottom of that. Body's being cleared everywhere. It's picked up by Colm Rigney. He's the youngest of the Rigney brothers. Donald, Brian, Des, Colm. And as we were saying earlier, Tony, there's another one as well. Hurling star. Now it's time for Conn to come on the counter. Over halfway. Martin Steffert's lost his scrum cap. And O'Mara to push them back again with that teasing kick. Stuart Traynor, no room to move and no place to go. And Conn up there with white shirts and numbers inside the 22. Play breaking down, Conn get the scrum. Well now, scrum to Conn, and a very sharp blast on the whistle there. And Steve McIver being called over. And so too is Robert Lee, and Lee gets a yellow card. Not quite sure what that was for. Whatever happened, it happened over there, long way away from us. And it's a penalty, which I'm sure O'Gara will take his time over, Tony.
Yeah, the kicking of the halfbacks this half, both O'Gara and O'Mara, has been very impressive. I mean, it's a very simple game. They're putting the ball in behind the Buccaneers' wingers and they're pressurising. And from here to the end, if they want to win this game, I think at this stage it is one at double scores, but certainly they're in total control.
Okay. That's the way it is in the lush grass of Temple Hill. I wonder, does he think it's over? Well, he's a bit more despondent than he was at the start of the match. This is not an easy kick. Six shots at goal he's had in the match so far, and he's got four of them. Here we go. Oh, certainly the crowd like it again. No mistaking it at this time. He's certainly got his kicking boots on now. He hasn't looked back, Tony, since that kick just before halftime.
Yes, I agree. Certainly there's no doubt for me who the man of the match has been. That man in picture there has had a huge game and a huge influence on the score, certainly at this stage. And in every respect, Jim, not just his kicking. His goal kick has been very good, but he's varying his game so well. A very impressive performance by the Cork Conn number 10.
Richard Larkin's come on. Not quite sure who's going off. It could be Tom Stewart Traynor. So a rejig in the Buccaneers' back line. And Allnut starts off once again. Just about 7 minutes left of normal time. Big, big lead now for Cork Conn. And they must be odds on at this stage to see Lansdowne Road next week. Well, that one wasn't touched, and the Cork Conn supporters hoping it'll stop in goal. And it's with them today, so it does.
Judge to the last inch. It really is Conn's day.
Well, it's a pity that Colm Rigney can't celebrate his 21st birthday with a win. It's not over yet, but today he is 21. And here goes Allnut. Allnut away. It bumped into Brian Walsh, who held the line. And quickly taken this time by McIver. Turned by Soden. This is a nice long drive by Buccaneers. Colm Brennan goes to ground. Here's Steffert. Steffert to Gormley. And big Conn body stopping that flow. Down goes screen once again. They've made it up to the 22. 18. Colm Rigney. Most of them are alike, the Rigneys, except for Des, who has black hair. And they're still going. Good passage of play. But if they could finish it off with a score, they'd be better pleased. You've got to be careful now, they don't get involved in any indiscipline. They're going to take the short penalty. Or are they going to kick it? Yes, I don't think they're calling a ball, though. At least they haven't so far. Well, there's Brian Rigney. Ah, it's all not. They've changed their mind and put themselves into good position here. Now, this is where Cork Conn scored a try before. McVie now with the throw. Good take by Rigney. McIver, McVie came around to stand out and see what he could do. The first phase. Now they can go left or right, and it's McIver. Out to Devine. No room there. O'Mara had him all the way. Well, you've got to give them credit. They're still battling on. 16 points they are trailing. And I think it was knocked on. Bodies now beginning to tire very rapidly. And Frankie Sheehan's on the floor. A very talented young man, Tony, as you know. Captained the Irish under-21s last year. A full professional rugby player. And I see Ken Murphy on the sideline, Tony. And I think he's been sin-binned. There he is anyway, Ken Murphy. And that's 10 minutes. But it's his clubmate who's hurt, Frankie Sheehan. Now, what are they going to do? Penalty to Buccaneers. It's from a situation like this that Dave McHugh gave a penalty try yesterday. That one isn't a penalty try at all. They stayed back the 10 yards. Buccaneers are right up to the line. Bodies everywhere, and the try awarded. Martin Stafford is there, but at the bottom of it all, you'll see now, is Mike Devine. Well, he made the initial move. It's his third try, and this really is a very talented player. We haven't seen the best of him today, Tony, but we'll try and see the try again here. Making the drive up to the line, held a good bit short, so they needed a solid surge to get over that. Now there was Cahill going in, and still they're short. Ref absolutely perfectly positioned, but look at the body coming through to put the ball over the line for the try. Devine gets his third try. Here's Allnut. If he gets this, they'll be up to 20. It's there. Never moved. Nicely struck. They're galloping out of time. Just 2 minutes left of normal time. And still they trail by 9 points. Still looks beyond them, Tony.
But full credit to them. I mean, they've never given up. But as you say, Jim, it took a few efforts to eventually get across the line here. But Eddie O'Sullivan asked them to give it everything they've got, and they're certainly not letting him down. And in the end, you have to say, a fully deserved try. It's still a long way back, but they're fighting all the way to the final whistle.
Yes, full credit to Buccaneers. They can certainly hold their heads high, there's no doubt. And Mike Devine smuggled himself in there for that try. Player of the year last year, and a very talented player. Plays for Offaly. And Buccaneers want it again to see if they can get something going from their own 22. Allnut, Stafford. Inside Gormley is there with him. And they have it again. This is Rigney once more, Colum. Conn offside, they're offside by a long way, and David Corker is the one who seemed to be offside. Back they must come, the 10. And David Corker is not one bit pleased with that decision. Allnut, he didn't get much ground there. It's a curious decision to know there, Tony, whether they should have run it or whether they should have kicked it, because they haven't made much.
Yes, I agree with you. I thought there he would have taken a quick tap and run it, because really they've just got to throw caution to the wind now and spin it wide, and they do have backs capable of running.
Up goes Donal Rigney, McIver, Allnut. Plenty of backs, and Stafford trying to make the first line, but they haven't got over the gain line yet. Call halfway the gain line in this move, and they've got the scrum. 30 seconds of normal time left. Now I've just been told that Brian O'Mara has been named man of the match. And Donica O'Callaghan is coming on, number 21. And Donal Sheehan is on, so now we've got Alton O'Callaghan, who left the field earlier, to be replaced now by his younger brother, Donica. Still scrambling for it. Here's Martin Cahill. There's no room there at all. The halfway line is still a good yardstick. Now it's injury time. And 9 points between it. It should be safe for Cork Conn. But only the referee at this stage knows how much we're going to play. MacIver waiting to put in as the seconds tick away. And Cork Conn will be very relieved that this match is over. When they met in the league, of course, Conn won 32-25, so they've had high-scoring matches between them. 49 points in this match so far. Steffert, MacIver, now he's over the game line. It might have been fractionally forward. Steffert stopped. Here's into the Conn half. MacIver waits once more. Has to go himself this time, perhaps. Oh, well done, Colin Brennan. Or Owen Brennan picking up. Very good play. But Conn have turned it over. O'Gara will plant it way downfield. Way over Larkin's head and into touch. And that really has sealed it. Touch and go as to who should be man of the match, Tony, between Ronan O'Gara and Brian O'Mara. But they've given it to the captain, Brian. But that was a terrific kick.
Well, there you hear the announcement, Jim, in the background. They've given the man of the match to Brian O'Mara. I must say I would have gone very certainly for Ronan O'Gara, his partner. But both Conn halfbacks have been very good. Brian O'Mara has played well, but for me, O'Gara has been absolutely outstanding.
Well, he's been the playmaker all right in the second half. There's no doubt he's pushed Conn down here several times and has kicked all his penalties. He's had a terrific second half, especially with the place kicks. Four penalties he's got. Three in the second half. Well, fair play to Buccaneers. Colm Rigney still playing, trying to run it out of their own danger zone. At this stage, of course, it doesn't matter if they concede another try, but if they could get one. And Cobb, well tackled by Kelly. As the ref looks. And Conn want the final whistle to go. They'd be mightily relieved with this, but they have played like a very mature side, Cork Conn, the second half. They didn't lose their shape, they didn't lose their confidence, and when they were 5-13 down, certainly Bucks were well in control. But they played very well.
Yes, they have. It's been a very pragmatic performance in the second half. They've done the simple things well and very effectively.
That's a good shove by the Bucks pack. Penalty against Conn. They must run it, have to run it. Game to the end, throw it out to Brennan. Steffert's with him, there he is, Steffert. Oh, nearly intercepted by Kelly. Kelly's turned it over. Advantage being played to Conn. Penalty against Buccaneers. And it will be a penalty too, for going around the wrong side. Now this will probably be the last kick of the match. Colin Murphy is prepared to come on the pitch and Brian O'Mara is going to go off. So it's a couple of seconds for Colin Murphy and man of the match Brian O'Mara goes off having done a real good job this afternoon. Colin Murphy on. I wonder will he get a chance to feed the scrum. I doubt it somehow, Tony. He mightn't even get to touch the ball. We've had nearly 4 minutes of injury time now. And this might be the last kick of the game. 139 points Ronan O'Gara has scored now in the AIB All-Ireland League. Four penalties and a conversion so far in this match out of seven kicks. Away it goes. Should be no problem for him, and I think it isn't either. It's all the way over the bar, and that is the last kick of the game, and Cork Conn are into the final of the All-Ireland League. It's disappointment for Buccaneers. I was talking to Eddie O'Sullivan this afternoon, and I was listening to him yesterday when he was saying, well, it was the icing on the cake to get into the top four and then to get into the semi-final. was the cream on the icing of the cake, and I asked him what he would do if he got to the final. He said that'd be the cherry that went on the cream on the icing on the cake, but sadly for Buccaneers, it was not to be. The scores, and Cork Conn well worthy of their win by 32 points to 20. O'Driscoll got a try, and Brennan got a try in the first half for Buccaneers. In the second half, Kelly got one, and O'Brien got one, and Devine got one for Buccaneers. Allnut got two conversions, Ronan O'Gara got one. But O'Gara got four penalties and a conversion, and he had a huge impact on this match. Simon Allnut kicked two penalties for Buccaneers, and the final score then leaves a very relieved Cork Conn into the final against Gary Owen next week with a big score here of 32 points to 20. So they'll face Gary Owen again. Gary Owen, of course, in the final for the second year in a row. Munster again, Tony. Munster again.
Munster it is again, and you have to say deservedly so. Cork Conn today really did play well, particularly in the second half when it mattered. Very simple game. They played it deep in the Buccaneers' half. They made it difficult for them to play. And at the end of the day, Ronan O'Gara dominated. They deserve to be there, and it should be some final.
Indeed it should. Certainly Cork Conn have come right just at the right time. And the hordes of support which have come down from Ballinasloe and Athlone and other points in the West have now to go home a bit disappointed, but they can be well proud of the Buccaneers team. They've got strength and depth here. They've done themselves proud in their first season, and after they beat Galwegians in the first match, they went on to terrific things. I think they themselves were a bit surprised to find that they got here to the semi-final, but of course they've got something like £15,000 now, I think, to add to their team coffers, which will help certainly to keep things going for the next year or so. Buccaneers then absolutely can be very proud of themselves, and Conn, though, it's their day. Michael Lester.
Yes, thanks, Jim. Well, as you can imagine, great excitement here around Temple Hill at the moment, as Cork Constitution have very deservedly and very impressively booked their place against Gary Owen in next weekend's final. Ronan O'Gara, what a hero he was in that second half. Perhaps his most impressive kick was the last one, although it didn't really matter on the scoreboard at that stage, as he took that penalty and took it so successfully. There was a helicopter landing directly in his line of vision behind the posts. Somebody doing it in style here today arrived a few minutes before the match by helicopter, and the helicopter was there to pick them up again and take them away from this victory. Jim Glennon, obviously you were impressed with what you saw in the second half. It had looked so good for Buccaneers at half-time.
Yes, Michael, looked very well, in fact, at half-time. And even for the first few minutes of the second half, they stuck at it well, got a couple of breaks. But really, once Ronan O'Gara and Brian O'Mara settled down to the task at hand, they were absolutely superb. And I think St Mary's College yesterday in Gary Owen could well take a leaf out of their book. Their ability to read a game and kick for position and then take all the right options was absolutely superb. And I know that Brian O'Mara got man of the match, but I certainly would agree with Tony Ward. I thought Ronan O'Gara was absolutely outstanding.
You said to me at half time that if Buccaneers could weather the first 10 minutes of the second half, then they were in with a real good shout. Mm. But in actual fact, the first try came against them just within that period.
Yeah, I think I was checking my watch for that particular reason, and I think it was 7 minutes into the second half. It was a very well worked score. Again, Conn sucked in Buccaneers, made the space. We see it here. Ronan O'Gara again, good ball, and we have the crash ball coming. Dave Corkery setting it up nicely. And it comes back. Brian O'Mara again, beautiful service. Out it goes, Ronan O'Gara. Beautiful little chip for David O'Brien to run onto. Des Rigney there, unfortunate with the bounce, but certainly Dave O'Brien did extremely well. And it was very perceptive football again, I thought, from the halfbacks. And beautiful little chip ahead. Yes. Very good try.
Kelly with the try there on that occasion. Well, the black and amber were not successful here, unfortunately, at Temple Hill today. But Eddie, thank you very much for coming to join us. You made a great goal, a great attempt, but it wasn't to be in the end.
No, I think the first thing I have to say is congratulations to Conn. They put in an exceptionally good performance. I think we had them shook a bit coming up to half time, and I think we needed maybe another score before half time to really set doubts in our mind. But
yeah,
they got an important penalty before half time, and they started the second half very well, and they created two very good tries. I thought Brian O'Mara had a very good game at scrum half, and definitely the man of the match was Ronan O'Gara for me. He had a superb game, controlled the game in the second half brilliantly, and set up some excellent scores for them, particularly that chip through. So, you know, all in all, I mean, you have to say, take your hat off to Conn, say congratulations and wish them well in the final. My own boys, I think, you know, probably it's the end of the road, I suppose, of the season anyway, and I think they're a bit disappointed down there, but we have to take stock. I mean, if we weren't going to win the league, there was going to be a day like this where we'd lose. And
yeah.
I think, to be fair to the team, they gave their all, and we met the wall today, and we stopped it. But I'm very proud of them. They have a great season. I think the key for Buccaneers at the moment now is to take stock again and make sure this is not a flash in the pan. And the next year, we're back in the league again, and we're fighting for the top four again. And that's all we can do is keep working away at it.
Eddie, it won't be too much consolation inside in that dressing room this evening, but it's really been a marvellous two seasons now for the club.
Yeah, they've been on a roll, you know. I mean, in fact, coming out of the third division, second division, the first division, it's been a great, great run. And supporters have been tremendous again. They're here today in full voice. The club has really structured itself very well, and I think it's good that clubs that get themselves organised get their just rewards. And today was a just reward. And it would have been great to go all the way, but, you know, it wasn't to be this year. But it was a hell of a step to take in our first year, and we're all cognizant of that. And we're very happy with the season. And take credit to the players, the supporters, and the club organisers. It's really been a great year.
Eddie, I know you want to go and talk to your players. Thank you very much for coming to join us, and well done all season.
Thanks, Mike.
Well, now, you mentioned, Eddie mentioned there a moment ago, this particular man, Ron McGarra. First of all, congratulations to you. You're showing the signs of battle, obviously. You had to work, you as a club had to work, and you personally had to work very hard in that second half.
Yeah, it was very draining out there today. The pitch took a lot out of the legs this afternoon. We started quite slowly. Our pack didn't get on top till midway through the second half. We had the aid of the elements, made it an awful lot easier. We could just place the ball down there, and therefore things worked out in the end.
Yeah.
We still have an awful lot of work to do before next Saturday, you know. You have to admire the way Gary Owen performed with 14 men taking on Mary, so it's a step on the way, but next week is the big step for us.
At half-time, when you got into the little huddle out there on the field, just exactly what was being said? Because it wasn't looking too clever at half-time for you.
No, not at all. It's the first time in a while I've seen a few blank faces among the pack at half-time. I don't think they were sure what had hit them, especially after last week's performance against Shannon. We were really up for that. But Buccaneers came at us as they truly would, and took us a while to knuckle down to the task, but I must praise our own back row and our front five for sticking at it. They're up against massive men, the likes of Stone, Scal and people like that, you know, so it's not easy.
Yeah. Obviously, you're looking forward to next week. Now, can you do it?
I hope so. It's going to be very tough. It's against Gary Owen. We know them well. They know us well. They have an awful lot. They have a very good team as well as we do, so it sounds well for a good final.
Roland, you deserve a Lucas Aid this evening. Well done, and thank you very much.
Thanks,
indeed.
Dylan.
Congratulations again. Okay, last word then to Jim Lennon. Jim, let's look forward to next week's final. It promises, obviously, to be a great occasion now. Always was going to be, I suppose.
Yeah, certainly. It really is the classic confrontation of Irish knockout rugby. The Munster Senior Cup has always been the quintessential tournament of knockout rugby in Ireland. And the two major exponents of it over a long number of years, over 100 years each, have been Cork Constitution, or yeah, Constitution, as they call themselves, and Gary Owen. And it really is a fitting stage, I think, for the two of them to come to Lands End Road. It'll be interesting to see how Gary Owen make up for the loss of Kieran Ronan, who was sent off yesterday. That'll be a big blow to them.
Yes.
I personally have fancied Corkon since the day I saw them beaten by Lansdowne in the opening day of the league, and I think they'll be very, very difficult to beat. And they have a team which, in my view, is going to be around for the next 5 or 6 years, and it's going to be, in my view, the outstanding team in Irish club rugby over the next number of years. I think they're ready to take up where Shannon left off.
OK, well, that's the big one for next Saturday. A lot more sport to come here on RT television, obviously, during the week. And the first later on this evening, which will be Sunday Sport. Of course, other league semi-finals on today. This was in the Church of General National Football League, Dublin against Armagh, and another Cork team, Cork against Meath. And that's on tonight at 9:20. Then on Wednesday night, we have that friendly international, the Republic of Ireland against Sweden, that you can also see here on RTE television. And then, as we mentioned a moment ago, next Saturday, it's the AIB League Final, live from Lansdowne Road. Gary Owen versus, yes, Cork Constitution, as confirmed here today. I hope that you enjoyed the match. We certainly enjoyed it here. From all of us in Temple Hill, bye-bye.